How can AI make a difference in the busy life of a small business owner? Let's find out in this next episode of the Cozy AI Kitchen. Welcome to this special episode of the Cozy AI Kitchen, where we're going to learn about how to address small business owner problems that are happening all the time. I have as my guest Sandeep Kalsi, who is entrepreneur and small business owner of the shipping shop that I always visit. Sandeep, welcome to the stage.
Thank you, John.
So tell me a little bit about how hard it is to run your shop. I, as a customer, see you running all the time, all over the place.
Retail is a critical, time pressure environment. There's a lot going on. There's a lot to do front end with customers and back end with the operations of the business. It's quite challenging because in a service business, trying to make time for customers is you know the paramount thing, and you get dragged into do other stuff which takes too long to do in an old retail world in many senses.
I had a colleague at Shopify who once told me that the life of a small business owner, I grew up in one myself, so mm-hmm. I saw it firsthand, is to have two buckets. One bucket is time, and the other bucket is money, and both are leaking all the time. Does that sound familiar?
Very much so. It's a hard environment. You're trying to train staff, you're trying to keep customers happy, you're trying to keep your reviews on track, all of that in a small time period during every day.
Time is of the essence. So because time is of the essence, and you've been able to take time out for this visit in the kitchen,
no,
we appreciate
welcome.
That. So we have two ways to cook the AI. Would you like a toaster or a hot pot?
I will go for the hot pot.
Hot pot, okay, yeah. There we go, hot pot. Okay.
It's that time of the year.
There we go. Oh yeah, it's a little winter cold here in Seattle area. So usually computer programs are made with old fashioned code. That's pretty hard to work with. But we now have something called semantic code.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't mind, can you add some semantic code to semantic kernel to get us going? And this kind of code is different because it uses words. Excellent, thank you. It uses words and enables us to actually create things out of words, not computer programs.
Mm-hmm.
And so here in the Cozy AI Kitchen, we've made a few recipes just for you.
Well, thank you.
Okay. Well, thank
anything
you
to make my world better?
Well, I mean, I see you all the time and it's like, wow, you're like a quarterback, you're the running, you're doing everything. So hopefully this can help. All right. So Sandeep Kalsi, this is something you mentioned about you recently installed self-service kiosks that helped somehow. How is that?
Massively. We have a high volume of parcels coming in, drop-offs, Amazon returns, other company returns in the thousands every month. And when that consumes your staff all day long, 8 to 10 hours a day, it's wearing. So the automations come in, self-scan, drop, scan, move on. We have happier staff and happier customers because we've busted the queues.
I mean, your team is so friendly too, by the way, just want to say.
It's good to hear.
Yeah, so you're saying that this sort of like a routine work they can now give to basically an AI kiosk.
There's a lot of routine work that could be digitized, nailed out with voice technology or other systems. I think most of retail is still doing things in the old-fashioned way, especially if you're a small boutique independent.
Hmm. Well, we have some code here to work with. I'm going to sort of bring over some packages, first of all.
Mm-hmm.
The semantic kernel is coming over. And it's arrived, and I'm setting some configuration. And what I've done is I've made it possible to do an inventory check. You have many paper corrugated boxes.
We do.
And so this is a picture I took the other day. And let's say you wanted to ask it how many boxes there are. You want to go ahead and click over here?
Sure.
So now what it's doing is it's setting that image to what's called
there are four boxes that read the UPS store in the image. They are stacked on top of each other.
So, example.
Fabulous.
I mean, you can't have these all over your store, of course, but example of the model can actually see things and interpret things too,
mm-hmm.
which is quite new. And I know you have this price sheet over here on one of the walls.
Yep.
And what I have it set up is if you press the button, you can ask a question. And when you ask a question, You only have roughly 15 seconds about that price list. So go ahead, hit play, and ask a question.
So what's the smallest box and how much does it cost?
The smallest box available is 06X06X06, and it costs $4.99.
So how is that interaction useful at all? I'm just wondering.
It's useful. If this was automated, it would just help us identify, you know, where to go. This is really, you know, on the back counter side, helping staff get to boxes, find their stuff, and get to the packaging and get stuff shipped faster and quicker. So it'll be helpful.
You're busy and reading takes time.
It takes time. It's not a huge space, but it's a good, interesting application that you've created here.
Okay, next up, you mentioned about how you have new employees coming all the time. Can you talk about that problem?
So retail generally faces the issue of like people coming and going. You have 50% of your crew is quite stable, and then you've got part-timers joining. And so training them, getting them up to speed, making sure the service is consistent, you know, over a period of time is quite a challenge.
So when I heard that problem, made a little recipe for made a little job description for this AI. You're a friendly helper in a shipping store that is an expert at managing the shipping experience for customers. And I gave it a manual of three tasks. One is building a customer. I recently did that. Thank you. I love the mailboxes. Finding a package and how to process returns. And if you don't know how to do it, say you don't know how to do it. So now what it'll do is, let's see here. How do you process a mailbox renewal? And there it is. So
Fantastic.
Again, notice they're gonna bother you, Sandeep. Yep. Okay, you can change the manual if you want to.
Yep.
Okay. And then you also mentioned how when you're sort of onboarding new employees and they're now sort of mature, you want to be able to maybe help with the employee training.
Mm-hmm.
And so this example is one where you can basically have a quiz. So if you hit play over there, you'll have that time where you can ask a question. It'll ask you a question. So it asks, how do you process returns? You ask Sandeep for the answer. Answer is incorrect. This is how you do it. You go to the kiosk. And so this is a way to kind of direct people to the right information.
Got it.
And of course, you control the manual. And lastly, given your own background in marketing and tech, I know you don't need this, but we made a little simple marketing collateral thing. So it says, create a slogan for a shipping store's promotion of available mailboxes. And when you run that, it goes off and makes a slogan. And with a slogan, it also generates an image.
That's fantastic.
So I can look at the image. This is an image I made previously. And there you have it. So, I mean, like, is any of this useful at all?
Very useful. You know, you don't have time for applying creative techniques to a retail business. So any slogans, any messaging that can elaborate and convey what you do in a beneficial way for customers is I'll take it on board.
So any sort of closing thoughts to folks out there, small business owners who are technology abled, but they're time starved?
I think you've got to look for the easy steps in finding where to start in automation. The costs of investing in AI tools and stuff may be prohibitive for small companies, especially if you're an independent, but there are quick fixes out there. And I think some of the voice-enabled technologies are very useful. Anything that can help you save minutes to help, you know, face customers would be, you know, much appreciated.
Wow, saving minutes. You heard it from Sandeep. Thank you so much for coming to the Cozy AI Kitchen, Sandeep.
John, it's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you. So keep on being out there, cooking with AI. It might be useful to you. You'll find out.